Commitment 2010 coverage now. With less than 6 weeks to go before the general election, the field in the races are set. And today, the candidates vying to replace Judd Gregg in the Senate squared off in a debate of sorts in Concord. And as expected, Paul Hodes and Kelly Ayotte really had no trouble finding differences of opinion.
Round one, Senate candidates Kelly Ayotte and Paul Hodes both go on the offensive on everything from the economy to a national energy policy.
We make sure that we don't pass cap and trade that Congressman Hodes has supported, because essentially that's going to be a national energy tax.
Ms. Ayotte denies the existence of climate change from any man-made activity.
That makes another key exchange fell on an issue that is hot button in every race on the national level: the request and use of taxpayer dollars attached to legislation for special projects, otherwise known as earmarks.
When I saw that everybody in the country was tightening their belts, I said, it's time to stop earmarks. It's $15 billion we can cut.
Well, Congressman Hodes has had an election year conversion on earmarks. I mean, he requested over 60 earmarks last year, and he's voted for 9,000 earmarks.
Following the forum sponsored by NHPR and New Hampshire Public Television, Ayotte and Hodes did find some common ground, as both agree that come November, New Hampshire voters have a choice on who best to help right the fiscal ship in Washington.
A true fiscally responsible candidate like me will cut the deficit and rebuild our economy.
It's ridiculous for him to call himself a fiscal conservative. I am a fiscal conservative. I'm going to cut back spending.
The Business and Industry Association partnered in forming this event. The Senate candidate forum will be broadcast, by the way, in its entirety tonight at 8 o'clock on New Hampshire Public Television.